everyone, it's your girl Natasha Martinez here, and you're watching American Latino TV, celebrating American Latino pride. And if this episode does anything, I hope it inspires you to rise up and chase your dreams. Why? Because kicking off today's show is the story of Mexican-American band La Santa Cecilia. For many longtime fans, it seems like just yesterday that they were hustling to be a part of unofficial showcases at music festivals like South by Southwest, pushing their mix of traditional Mexican music with influence absorbed from growing up in the U.S. Fast forward a few years, and the band has since become a major presence, even getting nods of recognition from the likes of Los Lobos and Elvis Costello for strong songwriting, musicianship, and hard work. They're showing and telling everything you need to know about their new album, Amar y Vivir, and you get to check it out right here on American Latino TV.
Let me take you down, 'cause I'm going to Strawberry Fields.
My name is La Marisol, and I'm the singer, screamer, and chillona de La Santa Cecilia.
Hola, yo soy Pepe, toco acordeón y requinto.
Hello, I'm Oso, and I play percussion in the band.
Hola, yo soy Alex, y soy el bajista, play the bass.
Por mi madre, yo soy mexicano. Por destino, soy americano. Yo soy de la raza de oro. Yo soy mexico-americano.
Marisol and Pepe met playing boleros since they were around 15 years old at Placito Olvera. And then Alex and me met at Cal State LA, studying Afro-Latin music together and jazz and stuff. And we were just all working around the city, you know, doing gigs. But we had a lot of desire to make our own band and do something original. So that's how La Santa Cecilia started up.
Como quisiera que tú vivieras.
This man named Beto Arcos, who's a radio DJ here on KPFK 90.7 here in Los Angeles, and he gave us our first opportunity. It was like at the Japanese American Museum, and we were so nervous and so excited because we were so thrilled to present La Santa Cecilia to the city. And La Santa Cecilia is something that represents a lot of faith for the four of us, and we're so happy to be able to be a band from LA, playing music from LA at the Hollywood Bowl. It means the world to us, it really does.
I mean, we're actually like celebrating 10 years. We've been getting messages, well, we've been going to Colombia a lot. We were just at La Feria de las Flores in Medellin. We get a lot of like messages from Chile, from Peru, and that like makes us really happy because Mexico and Latin America has always been such a big influence on our music. So we're like itching to just go everywhere, 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 you know?
El hielo anda suelto por esas calles.
Yeah, I think that in life there's a lot of obstacles always, no? But to us it's just a matter of focusing on your goal, you know? And we don't really like to dwell on the negative thing. I mean, we avoided immigration checkpoints when not all of us in the band had the proper documentation to travel in the United States. So those were interesting road trips of like an extra 24-hour drive to get to Texas, no, or something like that.
The detour.
The detours, yeah. But we were just an independent band. We were just a bunch of people that wanted to make music, and that's not easy, you know. We have this dream of playing music, and I think that's what's taken us, no?
And I think that our faith in the power of music, that's a very magical thing.
You do me wrong now. My love is strong now.
Man, being on stage, I think that's what we...
The best
feeling ever, because music does bring down borders, and there's nothing like that. There's no other feeling to us that would mean the same. Being on stage, you can share how you feel, you can... Especially when the crowd's really into it, I think.
Or when they're singing your songs. I think that's like one of the best things when we're singing, no sé, a song like Como Dios Manda, no? It's una ranchera. It's like a very sentimental song, and people are singing. That fills us with happiness, with satisfaction. Like, yes, that's what we're like working for, right?
Exactly.
To be right there with you guys.